أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ياسين والقرآن الحكيم. إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم. تنزيل العزيز الرحيم. لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون. لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون. إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون. وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون. وسواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. إنما تنذر من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب فبشره بمغفرة وأجر كريم. إنا نحن نحيي الموتى ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين. واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إذ جاءها المرسلون. إذ أرسلنا إليهم اثنين فكذبوهما فعززنا بثالث فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون. قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا تكذبون. قالوا ربنا يعلم إنا إليكم لمرسلون وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين. قالوا إنا تطيرنا بكم لئن لم تنتهوا لنرجمنكم وليمسنكم منا عذاب أليم. قالوا طائركم معكم أئن ذكرتم بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين. اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون. وما لي لا أعبد الذي فطرني وإليه ترجعون. أأتخذ من دونه آلهة إن يردني الرحمن بضر لا تغن عني شفاعتهم شيئا ولا ينقذون. إني إذا لفي ضلال مبين. إني آمنت بربكم فاسمعون. قيل ادخل الجنة قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون. بما غفر لي ربي وجعلني من المكرمين. وما أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم خامدون يا حسرة على العباد ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون ألم يروا كم أهلكنا قبلهم من القرون أنهم إليهم لا يرجعون وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون وآية لهم الليل نسلخ منه النهار فإذا هم مظلمون والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين وإذا قيل لهم اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم لعلكم ترحمون وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين وإذا قيل لهم أنفقوا مما رزقكم الله قال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا أنطعم من لو يشاء الله أطعمه إن أنتم إلا في ضلال مبين ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين ما ينذرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون فلا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم وامتاز اليوم أيها المجرمون ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا أفلم تكونوا تعقلون هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ومن نعمره ننكسه في الخلق أفلا يعقلون وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون واتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون أولم يرى الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم قل يحييها الذي أنشأها أول مرة وهو بكل خلق عليم الذي جعل لكم من الشجر الأخضر نارا فإذا أنتم منه توقدون أوليس الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم بلى وهو الخلاق العليم إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون صدق الله العظيم
اللهم آمين أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا وأهلنا وأولادنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا. اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباطنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. يا الله يا الله يا الله. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين، ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، سيدنا محمد رسول الله.
اللهم آمين آمين آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا، واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم. أستغفر الله 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 العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله، 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 سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. 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 فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا علي يا عظيم يا حليم يا عليم، أنت ربي وعلمك حسبي، فنعم الرب ربي ونعم الحسب حسبي. تنصر من تشاء وأنت العزيز الرحيم. نسألك العصمة في الحركات والسكنات والكلمات والإرادات والخطرات، من الشكوك والظنون والأوهام الساترة للقلوب عن مطالعة الغيوب. فقد ابتلي المؤمنون وزلزلوا زلزالا شديدا، وإذ يقول المنافقون والذين في قلوبهم مرض ما وعدنا الله ورسوله إلا غرورا. فثبتنا وانصرنا وسخر لنا هذا البحر كما سخرت البحر لموسى، وسخرت النار لإبراهيم، وسخرت الجبال والحديد لداود، وسخرت الريح والشياطين والجن لسليمان. وسخر لنا كل بحر هو لك في الأرض والسماء والملك والملكوت، وبحر الدنيا وبحر الآخرة. وسخر لنا كل شيء، يا من بيده ملكوت كل شيء. كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد. انصرنا فإنك خير الناصرين، وافتح لنا فإنك خير الفاتحين، واغفر لنا فإنك خير الغافرين، وارحمنا فإنك خير الراحمين، وارزقنا فإنك خير الرازقين، واهدنا ونجنا من القوم الظالمين، وهب لنا ريحا طيبة كما هي في علمك، وانشرها علينا من خزائن رحمتك، واحملنا بها حمل الكرامة مع السلامة والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا مع الراحة لقلوبنا وأبداننا والسلامة والعافية في دنيانا وديننا وكن لنا صاحبا في سفرنا وخليفة في أهلنا واطمس على وجوه أعدائنا وامسخهم على مكانتهم فلا يستطيعون المضي ولا المجيء إلينا طمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ياسين والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم تنزيل العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما طاسين حاميم عين سين قاف مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان حاميم 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 هم الأمر وجاء النصر فعلينا لا ينصرون حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير بسم الله بابنا تبارك حيطاننا ياسين سقفنا كاف ها يا عين صاد كفايتنا حميم عين سين قاف حمايتنا فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم ستر العرش مسبول علينا وعين الله ناظرة إلينا بحول الله لا يقدر علينا والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم بسم الله والحمد لله رب العالمين.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله لطيف بعباده يرزق من يشاء وهو القوي العزيز يا لطيف 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 لطيف يا 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 لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير اللهم يا من لطفت في خلق السماوات والأرض ولطفت بالأجنة في بطون أمهاتها ألطف بنا لطفا يليق بكرمك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله اللهم يا من جعلت الصلاة على النبي من القربات نتقرب إليك بكل صلاة سليت عليه من أول النشأة إلى ما لا نهاية من الكمالات بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه به في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك.
إن شاء الله we'll continue with ذكر جامعة. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وَسِعَهُ عِلْمُ اللَّهِ Inshallah, we'll make dua now. Allahumma ameen. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our Shaykh, teacher, murshid, and master, Sayyidina Shaykh Faisal Hamid Abdul Razak. O Allah, may you increase him in knowledge and wisdom. O Allah, may you protect him from evil, and we pray that he will lead his murids on the straight path towards you. O Allah, we pray for the Shaykh and his family. We pray that you strengthen them in Iman, keep them in good health, and grant them long life in Islam. O Allah, we pray that you protect them from all evil, ease their trials, and grant them the sweetness of paradise. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Allah forgive us for our sins and guide us on the straight path leading to paradise. O Allah, you know the needs of all of us present here. O Allah, answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our parents that you grant them your grace and mercy as they raised us in childhood. O Allah, grant our parents long life and good health in Islam. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive our parents and grant them paradise. O Allah, for our parents who have passed away and returned to you, O Allah, we beg you to forgive them. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the murids of Shaykh Faisal throughout the world. O Allah, we pray that you ease our trials and grant us the strength to face our trials. O Allah, make it easy for us to gain true knowledge and to practice it, to be good murids and to get ever closer to you. O Allah, you know the needs of all of the murids. O Allah, we beg you to answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the Muslims around the world. O Allah, we pray that you strengthen us in Iman. O Allah, we pray for unity and to make us stronger as a nation. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, please comfort and relieve all Muslims who are suffering and have suffered losses. O Allah, you are the all-powerful and the almighty. O Allah, we beg you to give us victory against the unbelievers. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for the International Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa. May you make it easy for us to establish many masjids for your sake. May you bless the Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa to be a beacon of light for Islam throughout the world. And may you help us to finish building the new masjid soon and make it easy for us to do so. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadan wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al-mursani walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله
اللهم آمين أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد صاحب التاج والمعراج والبراك والعلم دافع البلاء والوباء والقحط والمرض والألم
اسمه مكتوب مرفوع مشفوع منكوش في اللوح والقلم سيد العرب والعجم جسمه مقدس معتر مطهر منور في البيت والحرم شمس الدحى بدر الدجى صدر العلا نور الهدى كهف الورى مصباح الظلم جميل الشيم شفيع الأمم صاحب الجود والكرم والله عاصمه وجبريل خادمه والبراق مركبه والمعراج سفره وسدرة المنتهى مقامه وقاب قوسين مطلوبه والمطلوب مقصوده والمقصود موجوده سيد المرسلين خاتم النبيين شفيع المذنبين أنيس الغريبين رحمة للعالمين راحة العاشقين مراد المشتاقين شمس العارفين سراج السالكين مصباح المقربين محب الفقراء والغرباء والمساكين سيد الثقلين نبي الحرمين إمام القبلتين وسيلتنا في الدارين وسيلتنا في الدارين صاحب قاب قوسين محبوب رب المشرقين والمغربين جد الحسن والحسين جد الحسن والحسين مولانا ومولى الثقلين أبي القاسم محمد بن عبد الله نور من نور الله نور من نور الله يا أيها المشتاقون بنور جماله صلوا عليه وآله وأصحابه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين آمين آمين
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل
لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين، ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين، وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما، يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا. اللهم أعذنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، وأصلح لنا شأننا كله. لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. آمين آمين. أما بعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear Muris, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to this special program coming to you from the Islamic Forum of Canada, where we share with you this message of mercy from God Almighty to all of His creation. This is our daily broadcast, starting at 7 p.m. Toronto time or Eastern time, and coming to you from your zawiya here at the Islamic Forum. We thank you for joining us today for our broadcast, and we hope you can join us every day at 7 p.m. And we kindly request you to reach out to your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims that you know. Tell them about the program and encourage them to watch the program. Inshallah, they will benefit and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam says, "Man dalla ala khayrin fa huwa kafa'ilihi." If you get someone to do something good, then you will share in those blessings. So when you get someone to look at a program and they benefit from the program, you will share in those blessings. You will receive blessings, increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do remember to subscribe to the YouTube channel. Share the link with others, youtube.com/Sheikh Faisal. Subscribe to the channel by clicking on the subscribe button. Next to the subscribe button, there's a bell icon. Click on the bell and select all for notifications that you will be notified of all our different programs. Do remember as well to enter your information into the chat, your name and the city where you're from, and your updates on the different projects. The Gratitude Project, Salawat Project, Quran Project, and so on. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. Today, we also want to recognize and make special dua for our donors, all those who donated to the Islamic Forum today, yesterday, and before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. And make special dua for all our donors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, bless their families, bless their loved ones, enrich them many more times than what they donated to the Islamic Forum. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase them in His rizq and accept all their dua. So special dua for all our donors. And then for the sponsors of the dinner program, all the families, especially the sisters who have sponsored the dinner program, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. There are several requests for dua. We want to include all of your requests for dua in our need of dua as well. And special dua for all those who entered the information in the chat, their name, city, and their updates on the project. We make special dua for them because they've made the extra effort to enter and type in the information in the chat. So special dua for them. And special dua for each and every one of you. I want to make special dua for each and every one of you. Whatever dua you would like to make, you keep that in your heart and we'll make dua for you, inshallah. And then dua for my family and my mom and dad. And please, if possible, remember them in your dua as well. I want to also share this special appeal to you to donate to the Islamic Forum. Remembering the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ma naqasa malin bis sadaqa, your wealth will never decrease because of spending in the way of Allah. It will surely increase. Ma naqasa malin bis sadaqa. And in this particular hadith, the Prophet alaihi salatu wasallam took an oath by Allah. And then he mentioned these words, ma naqasa malin bis sadaqa, to emphasize the meaning of what he's saying. مَا نَقَسَ مَالٍ بِصَدَقَةٍ, your wealth will never decrease because of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will surely increase. So we encourage you and appeal to you to make a generous donation to the Islamic Forum, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. I also want to assure you that here for our program, we focus on our interest is your safety, your well-being, your afiyah. As the Prophet mentioned in the hadith, among the greatest gifts, among the greatest blessings you can have in your daily life is afiyah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We make dua for you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you afiyah in all the affairs of your life. And then your spirituality. We make dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you close to Him, keep you always in the shade of His mercy. Your spirituality, your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your connection with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We also have some special short video clips that our staff here at the Islam Forum have prepared for you. And we want to offer this to you as a special gift for each and every one of you. So the short video clips, what we call the editor's pick. And then a special series of video lectures on the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we offer these as gifts for you. If you'd like to receive the link for these short video clips and then the seerah series, do send us an email with your contact details, your email address, and your WhatsApp number if you have one, so we can send this information to you. And now we'll make a special dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you on this blessed occasion, inshallah, before we continue our program for today. So please raise your hands and join me in dua. Allahumma ameen. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا
وأهلنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا. اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب دعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباطنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله. اللهم آمين آمين آمين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in tawfiq and kubul and ziyadah. I also want to remind you once again of the special ongoing projects, the gratitude project, the salawat project, and the Quran project, for you to be mindful that you engage with these projects every day and then enter the update, your update, in the chat. Today I want to focus on the Quran project to say something about the virtues and the blessings of reciting the Quran. The Quran project is to recite at least one page of the Quran every day. This is the starting point, the first step. Start from the beginning of the Quran and go through sequentially until you finish the Quran, inshallah. So recite one page of the Quran every day at least. There are days when you may have more time, you can recite more of the Quran. And it's based on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Quran, in Surah Al-Kahf, chapter 18, verse 27. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
وَاتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ كِتَابِ رَبِّكَ لَا مُبَدِّلَ لِكَلِمَاتِهِ وَلَنْ تَجِدَ مِنْ دُونِهِ مُلْتَحَدًا.
And recite what has been revealed to you of the book of your Lord, book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran. None can change His words, the words of Allah. And none will you find as a refuge other than Him, other than Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding us to recite this Quran. وَاتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ كِتَابِ رَبِّكَ. And so, responding to this command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have this beautiful, sacred, blessed Quran project to recite the Quran every day, at least one page. In other words, no day should pass you by except that you recite at least one page of the Quran. And it takes just a couple of minutes to recite one page of the Quran. So it's something that's doable, practical, and very blessed for you. It causes you to be counted from among the best of Muslims, the best of believers. In the hadith that's narrated by Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, the Prophet says, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best of you is the one who studies the Quran and teaches it to others. And by being part of this program, you are achieving this, to be counted from among the best of Muslims, the best of believers. Because reciting one page a day, you're studying the Quran. That's one aspect of the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. And then, as you invite others to look at the program, your family members, relatives, friends, and other Muslims you know, they look at the program, they learn more about the Quran Project, they join the Quran Project, and they because of they gain more knowledge about the Quran, you're contributing to that. And so you're counted from among those who are studying Quran and teaching it to others. You then would be considered to be from among the best of Muslims. The Prophet ﷺ says, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. I also shared with you this beautiful hadith that's reported by Imam Muslim in his Sahih and narrated by Sayyidina Abu Umama. عَنْ أَبِي أُمَامَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قَالَ سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه رواه مسلم. So the Prophet ﷺ says in this hadith, recite the Quran, recite this holy Quran, because on the day of judgment it will come as an intercessor for its reciters, for its companions. اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. The Ashab al-Quran, companions of the Quran. So by you reciting this Quran every day, at least one page, you're connected to the Quran, you become from among the companions of the Quran, the Ashab al-Quran. And then what happens? What's the consequence of that? The Quran will come on the Day of Judgment and it will intercede for you. And the Quran, pure, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the uncreated word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the intercession of the Quran. So what a great blessing for us. So I encourage you, make your niyyah to join the Quran Project if you have not done so. And then you start reciting your one page every day. Start from the beginning of the Quran and continue like this. The next hadith I want to share with you is a hadith which is reported by both Imam Muslim and Imam Bukhari. And that means it's muttafaqun alayhi, agreed upon. And narrated by Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. An ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu qala, qala nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ikra'u alayhi al-Qur'an. Faqultu, ya Rasulullah, a'akra'u alayka wa alayka unzila? Qala, inni uhibbu an asma'ahu min ghayri. فقرأت عليه سورة النساء حتى جئت إلى هذه الآية فكيف إذا جئنا من كل أمة بشهيد وجئنا بك على هؤلاء شهيدا قال حسبك الآن فالتفت إليه فإذا عيناه تذرفان متفق عليه. Subhanallah, what a beautiful hadith. So in this hadith, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, one day the Prophet ﷺ said to him, read out the Holy Quran to me. Read this, recite this Quran for me. I said, O Messenger of Allah, shall I read it out to you, whereas it was revealed to you? He said, the Prophet ﷺ said, I desire, I like to hear it from others. Then he began to recite the chapter Surah An-Nisa till I reached this verse. فكيف إذا جئنا من كل أمة بشهيد وجئنا بك على هؤلاء شهيدا. How will it be when we shall bring a witness from every nation and people, and we'll bring you, O Prophet, as a witness against them. When I said that, the Prophet said, Hasbuk al-an, sufficient it is for you. And then I turned towards the Prophet and I found his eyes overflowing with tears. The Prophet was crying, listening to the Quran. This is his relationship with the Quran. So here the Prophet mentioned that he loves to hear this Quran from others. So that's why he asked Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. The companion, Sahabas, they used to say that Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, this great Sahaba, noble companion, he had such a beautiful voice. When he would recite the Quran, the Sahaba said they felt as if the Quran was being revealed to them now. Such was his beautiful recitation of the Quran. And so he recited the Quran, and then the Prophet listened to him, and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was crying, tears overflowing from his eyes, listening to the Quran. SubhanAllah, this is his relationship with the Quran. This is what all of us should strive to be, have this close relationship with the Quran. And the final thing I want to mention today to remind you of is that the Prophet ﷺ says that when you recite the Quran, every letter of the Quran you recite, you get a blessing for it. And he mentioned, by way of example, when you recite Alif Lam Mim, you don't get one blessing or one thawab. For Alif, you get a thawab, a blessing. For Lam, you get a blessing. For Mim, you get another blessing. Such is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to love the Quran, bless us to recite the Quran, and make it easy for us to recite the Quran every day. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala count us to be from among Ashab al-Quran, the companions of the Quran. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa sallam.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين
يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا
واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا أكرم واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم وليأتيك رسول الله جاءك به إذا الكريم تجلى باسم منتقم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا واسع الكرم فإن من جود
النفس لا تقنتي من زلات عزومت إن الكبائر في الغفران كلمامي يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم لعل رحمة ربي هنا ينصبها تعتي على حسب العصيان في القسام يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم.
لا إله إلا الله 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 سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
الله الله
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا اللهم أعزنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأصلح لنا شأننا كله لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.
May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. We continue our reflections on this important topic on boycotting those who insult the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We reflect on this topic based on the story of a wonderful Sahaba who has a wonderful story, Sayyidina Thumama ibn Uthal. I want to review what we said in our previous lecture on this topic and then to continue from there. Sayyidina Thumama ibn Uthal was born in the year 580 AD from the Banu Hanifa tribe, which is located in the region of Al-Yamama in Central Arabia. And he became the leader of his tribe, and therefore one of the most powerful people in that part of the world, because his tribe was one of the most powerful tribes. In the sixth year of the Hijra, in 626 AD, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, now in Medina and establishing the religion in society, Medina being the home of the Muslims, the home of the Ummah, the base of Islam, he decided to go to the next phase, the next level or stage of the da'wah, the invitation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so he started to send invitations, public invitations, to important leaders, whether, and this is outside of Mecca Medina now, to other places, other regions, other countries, to invite them to Islam. This is, you can call this a third phase of the da'wah. The first phase was this stage of secret da'wah in the formative years in Mecca. Then after that, the stage of public da'wah in Mecca. And now the phase of international da'wah, to go beyond the Muslims and beyond the confines of Quraysh and Mecca and Medina to others. And we mentioned in a previous lecture about some of these individuals. He sent eight letters to eight important leaders, among them Caesar, the Emperor of Rome, Khosrow, the King of Persia, and these were the leaders of the two superpowers at that time, the Roman Empire and the Persian Empire. And among those that he sent this letter of invitation to was Thumama ibn Uthal, ruler of Banu Hanifa tribe in the Yamama region of Central Arabia. Sayyidina Thumama, at that time he was a non-Muslim, leader of his tribe, one of the most powerful rulers in pre-Islamic times. And when he received this letter from the Prophet, and the Prophet sent an emissary, a messenger, one of his sahabas, to go to Thumama to give him this letter of invitation. He received this letter, he saw this letter, but he became very angry that the Prophet, whom he considered to be, these are ordinary people, weak people, they don't have any strength, no powerful army, and so on and so forth, why is he sending me a letter? He became very angry. He rejected the letter. And he refused to listen to this invitation of truth and goodness. More than that, he felt a strong desire to go and kill the Prophet ﷺ and to put an end to this mission of Islam. And so Thumama ibn Uthal waited for a convenient time to carry out this design. And in pursuit of this aim, at one point in time, he met a group of Muslims near to where he was, Al-Yamama, and he killed them. He killed a group of Sahabas. And the Prophet ﷺ was very angry about this, very upset. And he made a statement making the blood of Thumama halal. It's like what we would say in the West in olden times, you declare a person to be wanted, dead or alive. That you, the Prophet made his blood halal, meaning that anyone can kill him because of what he did. He killed several companions of the Prophet ﷺ, unprovoked. They weren't attacking him. They weren't doing anything to threaten him. He just saw them. He was Muslim, but because of his anger and rage from before, he killed them. And then not long afterwards, Thumama decided to perform Umrah. And this is the Umrah of Jahiliyyah style, not the Umrah of the Islamic tradition, which changed later on. But the Arabs used to do that. They used to perform the Hajj and Umrah and so on to Mecca, because remember, all of them, that entire region, they looked to Mecca as the important place, the most sacred place, and they would come from all over, whether it's as far as Yemen and other places, the entire Arabian Peninsula and beyond, come to Mecca for Umrah during the year and for Hajj during the times of Hajj. But they would do this from the following the Jahiliyyah on Islamic practices. They had idols there, the Kaaba. They would pay homage to the idol, and their sacrifice was to the idols. That's was their Umrah. So he made his intention to do Umrah, and he wanted to do Tawaf at the Kaaba and just sacrifice to the idols at the Kaaba and so on. So he left the Yamama to go to Mecca, and he was on the outskirts of Medina, because that's on the way to Mecca. And when he was there, there were groups of Muslims patrolling the districts of Medina and outlying areas, looking out for strangers, for anyone who may be intent on causing trouble for the Muslims and so on. And one of these groups came upon Thumama, captured him, because he's a stranger, they didn't know him. And they took him to Medina, into the Masjid, Masjid al-Prophet, Masjid al-Nabawi, and they tied him to one of the columns in the Masjid. And then they waited for the Prophet to question the man and decide what to do with him. So Thumama is now captured by the Muslims. He is in Masjid al-Nabawi in Medina. And then the Prophet, when he was about to enter the Masjid, he saw Thumama. And he recognized him. He knew who Thumama was, because he's a great leader, one of the most powerful leaders in that region, head chief of the Banu Hanifa tribe. And he asked the companions, "Do you know who this person is that you have taken?" They said, "No, O Messenger of Allah." And then the Prophet told him, "This is Thumama ibn Uthal al-Hanafi. You have done well in capturing him. The Prophet told them. And then the Prophet did not enter the Masjid. He returned back to his home. And then he told his family to get what food they have and drink and send it to Thumama. You know, the Prophet wanted to treat him well. This is, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted goodness for Thumama, that the Prophet now starts to treat him well. He tells his family, get food and drink, take it to him, to Thumama. And then he ordered that his camel, his own camel, Al-Qaswa, to be milked for Thumama. Like, take milk from the camel, give it to Thumama. And that's a great honor. All this was done before the Prophet met him, like went out to meet with him physically. He saw him, recognized who he was, and he started to treat him in this honorable way. And the Sahabas, they are noticing this, that the Prophet ﷺ is treating this person in such an honorable way. Then, after Thumama had eaten and he was comfortable and so on, the Prophet approached him and he wanted to encourage him to be favorable to Islam and hopefully to become a Muslim. He asked him, "What do you have to say for yourself, Thumama?" Thumama responded, "If you want to kill me in reprisal, in revenge, you can have someone of noble blood to kill." And he's referring to revenge or the reprisal for what he did in killing the companions of the Prophet, a group of them that was in his near to his place. He said, secondly, if out of your bounty you want to forgive me, I shall be grateful.
La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah, fi kulli lamhatin wa nafasin adadama, wasi'ahu ilmullah. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah, fi kulli lamhatin wa نَفَّسٍ عَدَدَ مَا وَسِعَهُ عِلْمُ اللَّهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدٌ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ فِي كُلِّ لَمْحَةٍ وَنَفَّسٍ عَدَدَ مَا وَسِعَهُ عِلْمُ اللَّهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدٌ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
And the third thing he said, if you want money in compensation for my freedom, I shall give you whatever amount you ask for. Because he is the leader, the chief of his tribe, one of the most powerful tribes. So money is not a problem. He has all of it. The Prophet didn't say anything. The Prophet left. But he continued to send him every day at mealtime, send him food and drink and milk from his camel. Then the Prophet ﷺ went back the next day and he said, what do you have to say for yourself? Same question he's asking Thumama. And Thumama repeated the three things he said before that he said. If you want to kill me in reprisal and in revenge, you can have someone of noble blood to kill, meaning his blood is noble. He is the chief of his tribe. It would be like a fed in your hat, so to speak, for you to kill me. And then, if out of your bounty you want to forgive me, I shall be grateful to you. And thirdly, if you want money in compensation for my freedom, I shall give you whatever amount you ask for. So he repeated the same thing again. The Prophet ﷺ left, continued to send food for him and so on. Then the next day, the Prophet ﷺ again went to him and said, what do you have to say for yourself, Thumama? And so Muhammad repeated the same thing. So the Prophet then said, he told his companions, turned to his companions and said, set him free. Atlikohu, set him free. That's the Prophet said. Without doing any of the three things that Thumama said, you can do this. Without asking him for any compensation, for example, money. Didn't ask him anything. Just say, set him free, let him go. Then Thumama left Masjid al-Nabawi, Masjid al-Prophet ﷺ, and then he rode away on his horse until he came to a palm grove on the outskirts of Medina, near to Al-Baqi. Al-Baqi was a very fertile vegetation at that time, like a very fertile garden. Later on, it became the cemetery for the Muslims, and today it's perhaps the most famous cemetery in the Muslim world, the Jannat al-Baqiya, near to the Masjid of the Prophet ﷺ in Medina. It has the most number of Ahlul Bayt that are buried there in any cemetery. It has the most number of Sahabas that are buried there in any cemetery, and so on and so forth. Most number of Awliya and things like this. A very great place. So then it was vegetation. He stopped there, he watered his camel, he washed himself. And then, instead of continuing on his journey, he turned back and returned to Masjid al-Nabawi, to the Masjid of the Prophet ﷺ. And there he stood before a congregation of the Muslims, Sahabas, and he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his servant and messenger. That's what he said. Sayyidina Thumama, uttering the words of Shahada, He had actually, while he was there, a captive in the masjid, he was observing everything that was going on. How the Muslims are behaving 5 times a day, they're coming to pray. In between that time, at night, they're coming and pray tahajjud. He's seeing the Prophet, how the Muslims are treating the Prophet, how the Prophet is treating them, radiallahu anhum. Like this, he's observing all of these things. And then he left, and now he changed. He went back. The light of guidance entered the heart of Thumama. So he went back. Mentioned the words of Shahada. Then he went to the Prophet ﷺ and he said, O Muhammad, by Allah, there was never on this earth a face more detestable than yours to me. Now your face is the dearest face of all to me. Says that you were the person I hated most in my life up to this point. Now you're the one I love most. He changed, subhanAllah. Look at that transformation of Thumama. He said, I've killed some of your men, and now I'm at your mercy. Whatever you want to do with me, you can do with me. Because he now wants to get forgiveness for his sin to be expiated like that. And so whatever the Prophet wants to do that, do to him, he's willing to accept. SubhanAllah, a tremendous change. But the Prophet ﷺ responded in a beautiful way. The Prophet told him, O Thumama, there is now no blame on you. La tathriba alaykum. For becoming a Muslim wipes away your past actions and marks a new beginning. You're forgiven for all your past actions now because you've become Muslim. This is what Islam does. When someone takes Shahada, they become Muslim, all their past sins, all their previous sins are forgiven for them. They're starting a new beginning, like a newborn baby, innocent, free from sins. This is what the Prophet told Sayyidina Thumama ibn Uthal. Then Thumama was greatly relieved by this. His face showed his surprise and joy, and he vowed, he made a promise to the Prophet, by Allah, I shall place my whole self, my sword, and whoever is with me at your service and at the service of your religion, Islam. This is his promise, dedicated himself to serving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, Ya Rasulullah, when your horsemen captured me, I was on my way to perform Umrah. When they captured him outside on the outskirts of Medina, he was going to Mecca to perform Umrah. He said, what do you think I should do now? The Prophet said, go ahead and perform your Umrah. But perform it according to the laws of Allah and His Messenger. And the Prophet taught him how to perform Umrah according to Islamic rules. Remember, the Arabs were doing Umrah before, even though they were not Muslims, because they're paying homage to the idols of the Kaaba. So that was what he intended to do when he left Al-Yamama, his home, to go to Umrah from Jahiliyyah, to go to Mecca, perform Jahiliyyah Umrah. Prophet said, go to Mecca, do Umrah, but a different way. And he taught him how to perform his Umrah, that he would make his Niyyah and do his Turakat, and then recite on the way to Mecca, then he would enter and he would make his niyyah for Tawaf al-Qudum, perform Tawaf around the Kaaba. When he finished 7 rounds of Tawaf, he would go behind Maqam Ibrahim and perform the 2 rakat for Tawaf, then drink Zamzam, make dua, then do Sa'i between Safa and Marwa, the round, and clip his hair, shave his head to finish his Umrah. That, you know, like this. Prophet taught him the rules of Umrah. So Thumama left Medina and continued on to Mecca. When he reached the valley of Mecca, he did something amazing. Something amazing. He started shouting in a loud, resonant, beautiful voice, Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك سبحان الله. he is reciting Talbiyah. Here I am at your command, O Allah. Here I am, Labaik. And there is no partner with you, O Allah. Here I am, La Sharika Lak, Labaik. Praise and bounty and dominion belongs only to you, O Allah. No partner have you, La Sharika Lak. This is the words of Talbiyah that the Prophet ﷺ taught him, that he is reciting as he enters the Valley of Mecca. Now the Meccans are astonished at this, right? And so Sayyidina Thumama ibn Uthal became the first Muslim on the face of this earth to enter Mecca reciting Talbiyah. So not a first for Sayyidina Thumama ibn Uthal radiallahu anhu. Such a great transformation. Think about how he left his home with what niyyah in Yamama not long ago. Wanted to kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, for a long time he has this feeling in his heart to exact revenge, to kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to end Islam. Right? He left also niyyah now to go to Mecca to do Jahiliyyah Umrah. And now he's reciting Talbiyah to begin his Umrah. Such an amazing transformation. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants khair, wants goodness for a person, guides them to Islam. Subhanallah. The first person on the face of this earth to enter Mecca reciting the Talbiyah. So the Quraysh heard the song of Talbiyah. And they're angry now. And so some of them rush out with swords drawn. Senator is a voice to see who's doing this, wanting to punish that person. And as they came closer, Thumama raises his voice even louder now, reciting Talbiyah with pride and defiance. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, innal hamda wal ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. This Talbiyah is amazing. The Prophet says that this Talbiyah, when you recite it in a state of ihram, then the rocks and stones and trees next to you, they hear you, the Talbiyah, and they repeat it. And then the rocks and stones and trees next to them hear them reciting it, and they repeat it. And it continues like that until it reaches the far corners of the earth. Subhanallah. Sayyidina Thumama ibn Uthal, the first one who did this. And so everyone that's reciting Talbiyah after him, he shares in that blessing. What a great change. So the Quraysh coming closer to him, and then the young ones wanted to attack him. But then someone among them, an old elderly person, they recognized Thumama. And they told him, stop. Don't do anything to him. This is Thumama ibn Uthal, ruler of Al-Yamama. By Allah, if you should harm him in any way, his people would cut off our food supplies and we would be destroyed. So the young people of Quraysh who wanted to attack Thumama for reciting Talbiyah, they backed off. And then the older ones among them, Quraysh leader, says, what's wrong with you, Thumama? Have you given in and abandoned your religion and the religion of your forefathers? Because this is the main point they were always holding on to. Their religion and the religion of their forefathers, they cannot leave it. And they're willing to fight the Prophet, so even though they know, they recognize that he is speaking the truth, but they want to hold on to their ways. This is ignorance. He said, I've not given in, but I've decided to follow the best religion. I follow the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
And so they couldn't do him anything, because remember they said that if we harm him, his people, Al-Yamama, Banu Anifa, they'll cut off our supplies of food and we'll be destroyed. We wouldn't be able to survive without them. So the Quraysh are watching him and he's performing his Umrah as the Prophet instructed him. And then he did his sacrifices, Qurbani, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Not to the idols. That's what they are accustomed to. That they do sacrifice to the idols. He's doing it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he finished everything, before he left Mecca, he said, I swear to you by the Lord of this house, Lord of Kaaba, that after I return to Al-Yamama, no grain of wheat or any of its produce from Al-Yamama Bani Hunifa shall reach you until you follow the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. He said that. SubhanAllah, he left. He went back to his home, Yamama, to his tribe, Banu Hanifa. And then he announced a boycott, a total, complete boycott of Quraysh in Mecca, because they were insulting the Prophet ﷺ, they were opposing the Prophet ﷺ, they were fighting the Prophet ﷺ and the Muslims. You know, insulting the Prophet, saying bad things about him, taking advantage of the Prophet and the Muslims, how they treated them. So Thumama now, he has an upper hand, so he announced a boycott. And so he became the first Muslim or anyone who announced a boycott against those who were insulting the Prophet. Now, Al-Yamama was a fertile land, produced much vegetable, fruits, wheat, grains, all types of food products. And the Banu Hanifa tribe, Thumama's tribe, he's the leader, the chief of the tribe, they were the main food supplier to Mecca. Mecca was dry, arid land. They couldn't grow anything there, couldn't produce food for themselves, so they had to import it. And it was from Banu Hanifa tribe, Thumama's tribe, that they were getting their food supplies. The trade that they would do to the south, to the Yemen, Abyssinia, and so on, and to the north, Bilad al-Sham, it wasn't for food supplies and vegetables, because it took long to travel back and forth. So the vegetables and fruits would not survive. So they were getting their food supplies from Al-Yamama, Central Arabia, closer to them, all the food supplies. They would get other merchandise from those other places. So Mecca depended on Banu Hanifa for its food supplies. Thumama now, Sayyidina Thumama, imposes boycott. He stops supplying them with all the food products. And as we said, this is a forced boycott that was imposed by anyone on those who opposed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, done by Sayyidina Thumama. This boycott had a tremendous impact on Mecca and the life of everyone in Mecca. Food became in short supply, and became scarce. Prices of food items started to rise dramatically. Hunger began to bite. Poor people could no longer afford to pay the prices for the food. And even the rich people who had the money, they couldn't find enough. It's scarce supply because of the boycott of Banu Hanifa imposed by Sayyidina Thumam ibn Uthal. So this boycott done by one man, subhanAllah. And look at the impact it had. And all of this took place, this boycott took place during the lifetime of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And so the Quraysh had to change their attitude towards the Muslims. And then they sent a delegation to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, begging him to tell Thumama to lift the boycott because they're starving and so on. They had to literally humiliate themselves because they felt that they're so powerful and they were so arrogant in dealing with the Muslims. Now it changed. Their attitude towards the Muslims changed because of this boycott. No longer proud and arrogant and feel they can do with the Muslims whatever they want to do with them. The Treaty of Hudaybiyah, for example, very unfair to the Muslims, the Quraysh taking advantage of the Muslims. Now is changing because of one man, Sayyidina Thumam ibn Uthal, and the boycott he imposed on Mecca and the Quraysh. They went to Medina, they had to beg the Prophet ﷺ to tell Sayyidina Thumam to lift this boycott. Now, the other important thing that I want to mention to you about the contribution, the significant, critical, amazing contribution of Thumama, Sayyidina Thumama ibn Uthal, to the Muslim Ummah. There was a challenging time at some point, a fitna in the community, where a man by the name of Musaylama al-Kadhab, he declared that he was a prophet. He was a prophet. And so it's like he's challenging the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet declared him as Al-Kadhab. That's why he's known as Musaylama Al-Kadhab. But after the passing of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was people from far-flung areas, Arab tribes, that start renouncing Islam and following Musaylama. And it was Sayyidina Thumama ibn Uthal who responded to them. And he spoke to his people, Banu Hanifa. He says, "O Banu Hanifa, beware of this grievous matter. There is no light or guidance in it. By Allah, it will only bring distress and suffering to whoever joins this movement, and misfortune even to those who do not join it." Meaning the movement of Musaylama al-Kadhab, the false prophet, who's saying that he's a prophet and people should follow him. He says, "O Banu Hanifa," this is Thumama addressing his people, "two prophets do not come at the same time, and there shall be no prophet after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and no prophet to share his mission." There can be no prophet after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the final prophet. So he's telling them this. And then he recited from the Quran, from Surah Ghafir, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Hamim, tanzilul kitabi min Allahil azizil alim, ghafiriz zambi wa qabilit tawbi shadidil iqab, dhit tawli la ilaha illa huwa ilayhil masir. Hamim, the revelation of this book, the Quran, is from Allah the Almighty, the All-Knowing One. He forgives sins and accepts repentance. He is severe in punishment and has a long reach. There is no God except Him, Allah. And to Him is your final return, is the journey's end. And then he asks the people, "Can you compare these words of Allah with the uttering the lies of Musaylama al-Kazzab?" Yes. And so he gathered his army together. And he waged war against those people, Musaylama al-Kadhab, and those who were following him. And finally, they gained victory over him. So this was a great contribution of Sayyidina Thumam ibn Uthal that put an end to the campaign of the false prophet Musaylama al-Kadhab. He fought against him until victory was achieved. So these are some of the great contribution of Musaylama al-Kadhab. Many firsts in his life. Two amazing ones. The first Muslim to enter Mecca reciting the Talbiyah. Such a great honor. He did it. He started it. And then everyone that's doing it after him, he shares in that blessing. And then he was the first Muslim or anyone who impose a boycott on people because they insulted the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They opposed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They fought against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what he did to Quraysh. And he brought them to their knees, literally. Yes, they changed. They changed thereafter. So this is very significant, what he did. All this arrogance was removed. They had to come begging the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Included in that delegation was Sayyidina Sufyan. Yeah, yes. Who at that time still wasn't a Muslim, leader of Quraysh, one of the leaders. But they came to the Prophet begging the Prophet to tell Thumam, because Thumam, they could not go to him. He made his promise that this is what he would do. But they knew that if they can convince the Prophet to speak to Thumama to end the boycott, then Thumama would follow and obey the Prophet. A great example that I wanted to share with you on this topic of boycotting those who insult the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you to be close to him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to be able to defend the honor. That may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and guide you and show you the way to rise up and defend the honor of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the best of what we can share with you are the action points that we share in this program, especially the Salawat project, to recite much Salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you, show you the way to do what is good and acceptable to him, to defend the honor of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in wa akhir da'wan alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله
صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله
الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد أشرف العرب والعجم محمد خير من يمشي على قدمي محمد بسيط المعروف جامعه محمد صاحب الإحسان والكرم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد تاج رسل الله قاطبة محمد صادق الأقوال والكلم محمد ثابت الميثاق حافظه محمد طيب الأخلاق والشيم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد جبلت بالنور تينته محمد لم يزل نورا من القدم محمد حكيم بالعدل ذو شرف محمد مدين الإنعام والحكم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد خير خلق الله من مضر محمد خير رسل الله كلهم محمد دينه حق ندين به محمد مشرك حقا على عالم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد ذكره روح لأنفسنا محمد شكره فرض على الأمم محمد رحم الله العباد به محمد سبب الإنشاء من عدم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله.
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
نور ولا يحي نور لك الرأي يحي
نور ولا يحي نور لك الرأي يحي سارة عالم میں دیکھو کیسا نور چھایا ہے الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله جب تلك یہ چاند تارے جن ملاتے جائیں گے تب تلک جشن ولادت ہم مناتے جائیں گے جب تلک یہ چاند تارے جل ملاتے جائیں گے تب تلک جشن ولادت ہم مناتے جائیں گے نور والا آیا ہے نور لے کر آیا ہے سارے عالم میں یہ دیکھو کیسا نور چھایا ہے الصلاة السلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله نعت محبوب خدا سنتے سناتے جائیں گے يا رسول الله
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
لا إله إلا الله، 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. لا إله إلا الله، 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. إن في الجنة نهرا من لبن، إن في الجنة نهرا من لبن، لعلي وحسين وحسن، لعلي وحسين وحسن. لا إله إلا الله، 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. كل من كان محبا لهم، كل من كان محبا لهم، يدخل الجنة من غير حزن، يدخل الجنة من غير حزن. لا إله إلا الله، 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. كل من سار على دربهم، كل من سار على دربهم، يدخل الجنة من غير حزن، يدخل الجنة من غير حزن. لا إله إلا الله، 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. حب أهل البيت فرض عندنا، حب أهل البيت فرض عندنا، وبهذا الحب لا نخشى المهان، وبهذا الحب لا نخشى المهان. لا إله إلا الله، 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. لا إله إلا الله، 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا.
لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
قطب النقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى
أروح له أدنى ثمني. قطب النقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروح له أدنى ثمن. قد دل على المولى وسما في الفضل إلى أعلى كنن. قد دل على المولى وسما في الفضل إلى أعلى كنن. وتى في هذا العلم بما قد زاد على الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروح له أدنى ثمن. معرفة المولى غايته فاتبعه على هذا السنن. معرفة المولى غايته فاتبعه على هذا السنن. فاغرف من هاتيك السنن. قطب النقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروح له أدنى ثمن. وأساس بناء طريقته تطهير القلب من الدرن. وأساس بناء طريقته تطهير القلب من الدرن. فاسلك بالاسم المفرد يا صوفي وبالحق استعن. قطب النقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروح له أدنى ثمن. حب وافن عن الأكوان فما يبقى إلا من فيه فني. حب وافن عن الأكوان فما يبقى إلا من فيه فني. وادخل أبواب الغيب وسل ما شئت وللأسرار سهي. قطب النقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن
واستقني قطب الأقطاب مدى الزمن أشادني وأبو الحسن بحر الأسرار ما مودى أروه له أدنى ثمن قطب الأقطاب مدى الزمن أشادني وأبو الحسن بحر الأسرار ما مودى أروه له أدنى ثمن وقت اليعقوب جاهلا دعوى في أثواب الكفن وقت اليعقوب جاهلا دعوى في أثواب الكفن فقف يا مولاي عليه وعلينا جمعا بالمنن وكل قطاب مدى الزمن أشادني وأبو الحسن بحر الأسرار ما مهدى أروه له أدنى ثمن قطب الأقطاب مدى الزمن أشادني وأبو الحسن بحر الأسرار ما مهدى أروه له أدنى ثمن أروه له أدنى ثمن أروه له
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها محمد زينة الدنيا وبحجتها محمد كاشف الأمة والظلام محمد سيد طابت مناكبه محمد صاغه الرحمن بالنعم صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها محمد شرف الباري مراتبه محمد خصه الرحمن بالنعم محمد صفوة الباري وخيرته محمد طاهر من سعير صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
محمد عمانا إحسان نعمته محمد سر علم اللوح والقلم صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا
واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا أكرم الخلق ما لمن ألوذ به سواك عند حلول الحديث العمام يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم وليرضيك رسول الله جاهك به إذا الكريم تجلى باسم منتقيم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم فإن من جودك الدنيا ودارتها ومن علومك علم اللوح والقلم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا نفس لا تقنطي من زلة عزمت إن الكبائر في الغفران كاللمام يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم لعل رحمة ربي هنا يقصدها تعتي على حسب العصيان في القسام يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي
سيدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. أما بعد, my dear beloved respected brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of Almighty Allah be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to our daily live stream broadcast coming to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum of Canada. This program starts at 7 p.m. every day, Toronto time. We thank you for joining us today on this wonderful Tuesday evening here in Toronto, and we hope you can join us every day at 7 p.m. Do remember to reach out to your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know. Tell them about this program. Encourage them to watch your program. Remind them from time to time to watch the program and sign into the chat. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program. You'll receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yesterday was election day for the municipal elections here in Ontario, and specifically here in the GTA, the Greater Toronto Area, all the different cities. And this is the municipal election, so it's the third level of government. You have the national government or federal for federal elections, then the provincial elections for the provinces, and then the municipal elections for municipalities. For Brampton, Mayor Patrick Brown was re-elected. He has been a good friend of the Muslim community. He comes here to the Islamic Forum often on special occasions and so on. In Mississauga, Mayor Bonnie Crombie was re-elected as mayor, and she's also a good friend of the Muslim community. Yes, so alhamdulillah, good news. There were many Muslims who participated in the elections. Some of them won, some of them did not. But we want to congratulate all of them for the efforts they made to participate in the election. We encourage Muslim candidates to participate more and more in these elections at all three levels, municipal, provincial, federal, in this way, inshallah, to represent, to be there, and so they can defend and represent the interests of Muslims, inshallah. So congratulations to all those candidates who won, and all those who participated as well. I wanted to mention that. And in our khutbas and announcements and so on previously, we were encouraging Muslims to go out and vote. The turnout of voters was relatively low, in the 30s. So many people did not vote. So if Muslims can participate, it would be very effective. It would be very effective. They can make a difference in many of the wards or constituencies who win. So we once again want to encourage all of you to participate in these elections and go out and vote, inshallah. The next thing I want to mention to you, we have a special weekly television program which is on every Sunday morning from 6:30 p.m. to 7 p.m. on Yes TV. That's Yes, Y-E-S, Yes TV station, which is Channel 9 in the Greater Toronto Area and Rogers TV. And if you have another provider for your cable services such as Shaw or other providers, then you can check for Yes TV, Y-E-S, Yes TV. And then you can be able to look at this program. It's broadcast nationally in Canada every Sunday morning from 6:30 a.m. to 7 a.m. And you can, for those of you in Canada, you can program your television to record the program. Let's say you're busy at that time, Sunday morning, and you're not able to look at the live program. Then you can program your television to record the program. So you program for, put an ongoing program to record this television program for Sunday morning, every Sunday morning, from 6:30 a.m. to 7 a.m. And the name of the program is Message of Mercy. Message of Mercy. So once you finish your live stream tonight, then I would request you to program your TV to record the program every Sunday, inshallah. And let us know when you do that, when you program your TV to record the Message of Mercy program, which is every Sunday morning at 6:30 a.m., from 6:30 to 7 a.m. And the name of the program is Message of Mercy. Let us know about that, inshallah. I think it's very good if you can do that, to look at the program and encourage others to do likewise. Alhamdulillah. We would like to remind you of the special Remembrance Day Maulid, which we are having on the Remembrance Day weekend. So on the Sunday, November the 13th, 2022, starting at 12 noon here at the Islamic Forum. So we hope you can register if you haven't already done so. And to register, you just type in the chat that you will be attending the program. And this is a physical attendance here at the Islamic Forum. So basically, the focus is on those of you in the GTA area, or those of you out of town, if you can come on that weekend to Toronto to visit your relatives, friends, and so on, and then you can join us on this Sunday, the 13th of November at 12 noon here at the Islamic Forum. We'll mention the names we have on the registration sheet or form for the program so far. So if you don't hear your name, it means you did not register. And you have you should register, inshallah, as soon as possible, because registration is required to attend the program. Siti Hafiza, Siti Azam, Siti Safiya, Siti Hussein Al-Faisal, Siti Amar Al-Faisal, Siti Samir Al-Faisal, Siti Sharif Al-Faisal, and his wife is Halima, Sister Mariska Jenny, Brother Muhammad Mu'azzam, Siti Razia, Sister Shireen Shah, Sidi Zairul Khan, Sister Noreen Yaqub. Those are the brothers and sisters that have registered so far for this program, the Remembrance Day Maulid. Alhamdulillah. And also we remind you of the special Surat al-Ikhlas Khatam that we are doing on behalf of Al-Hajj Sheikh Amir Khan, one of the great Waliullah of our times who passed away recently, and we're doing the Surat al-Ikhlas Khatam for him on his behalf. And we divided that into shares of 1,000 Ikhlas, 1,000 recitation of Surat al-Ikhlas. So we like you to take start with at least one share, but that's a minimum, one share that you can do, inshallah. And every day you you can recite maybe 100 Surat al-Ikhlas. So in 10 days you'll finish it, inshallah. So it is throughout the season of Rabia, Rabia or Rabia Thani, that we're doing Sakhatam, inshallah. And those that have done so already, registered, taking pledges, Sidi Amar al-Faisal, 1,000 Ikhlas, Sidi Karina Muhammad, 1,000, Sidi Mariam Magi, 1,000, Sidi Bilal Magi, 1,000, Sister Shireen Shah, 1,000, Auntie Betty, 5,000, Sidi Zairul, 3,000, Sidi Dr. Tahir Chowdhury, 1,000, Sidi Ali Khan, 2,000, Sidi Halima Khan, 2,000, Sister Roxana Begum, 1,000, Sidi Naim al-Faisal, 1,000, Sidi Naim Ali, 1,000, Sidi Rani Rahman, 1,000, Sidi Samuel al-Faisal, 1,000, Sidi Ismail al-Faisal, 2,000, Sidi Raja Khan, 1,000, Sidi Hussein al-Faisal, 1,000, Baramateen Munshi, 1,000, Sister Bibi Rasul, 1,000, Sidi Sharif al-Faisal, 1,000, Sister Noreen Yaqub, 1,000. Those that are brothers and sisters that have taken their pledges so far. So we want to encourage all of you to take a pledge. Just start with one share of 1,000. When you finish that, you can take another share like that. And in the chat, you let us know when you take your pledge. And then every day you update us how many Surat al-Ikhlas you've recited from the total pledge, how many you took a total, inshallah. Tonight is also a special night. It is the beginning. Tonight is the first night of the second half of the season of Rabia Thani. So tomorrow is the first day of Rabia Thani. So we want to wish you Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings. So the second half of the season of Rabia is here. So all the things we were doing for the first half, we continue for the second half of Rabia Thani, or the Rabia season, so Rabia Thani. So wishing you Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings, inshallah. And also we continue with the Maulid Mubarak greetings. What's the lecture you did tonight again? The lecture tonight. One of the Rabia lecture. Alhamdulillah for that. Alhamdulillah. So in your greetings now from tonight, you would start with Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings. Inshallah. May Allah bless you all for doing so. We want to thank all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them and all of you, including Sister Shakir Ishmael, Brother Sunny Ishmael, Brother Nadeem Mateen and family, Brother Shahriyar Mahmood and family from Mississauga. Brother Marcus Rushing from the United States. Brother Muhammad Marzam, Sister Mariska Jenny from Mississauga. Sister Brenda Williams from Harlem, New York. Thank her for her frequent, regular, generous donation to the Islam Forum. Siti Mariam McGee and family from Richmond, Virginia. We thank you for your donation to Islam Forum. Sister Zahira Abba and family. Sister Siobhan Dubé make this donation on behalf of Sister Halima Khan Dubé, Sister Shaliza Karimullah, and Siobhan Dubé. We thank them for their donation. Alhamdulillah. And Sister Siobhan says, beautiful khutbah every Friday. We look forward to that. Alhamdulillah. We thank you for your donation. The Dubé family from Ajax. Siti Wajma Wardak, Sister Shamila Hamid from Woodstock. Thank you for your donation. Sister Narissa Dean from Newmarket. Thank you for your donation. Sister Shazia Wan from Manchester, United Kingdom. This is Denise Wan, this is Siti Mariam from Rochdale, United Kingdom. Thank you for your donation, alhamdulillah. Brother Asif Hassan and family from Brampton. Siti Salia Khan. Siti Dr. Tahir Chowdhury from California. Brother Abrar Mufti and family from the UK. Sister Shaliza Yaqub and family. And the Yaqub family, we thank all of them, inshallah, for their donation. May Allah SWT bless all of them and all of you. Alhamdulillah. We'll go through the chat. You can put your information in the chat, your name, city where you're from, and the update on the different projects. The book that we are featuring in this season of Rabia, both the first half and the second half of Rabia, the book Blessings of Salawat. We encourage you to get your copy of the book. You can click on the link in the chat, at the top of the chat, to get your copy of the book, inshallah, and you can get additional copies for your loved ones, family members, relatives, friends like this, that you can give it to them as a gift, inshallah. So Blessings of Salawat. Also, our Islamic school every Saturday from 10 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. You can bring your children this Saturday at 10 a.m. to register for the school. We have classes for students from grades 1 to grade 12, the entire range of grades. You can register them. And you can tell other Muslim families, you know, if they have children in that age group, they can bring them on Saturday and register them for the Islamic school. Alhamdulillah. At the top of the chat as well, we welcome Sister Janna Taylor from Richmond, Virginia. Thanks for joining us, Sister Janna Taylor. We hope you can join us every night, inshallah. And do remember to always have your notebook ready, and you can take notes from the lectures that we're doing. And you can ask any questions in the chat. Keep in regular contact with Siti Mariam, inshallah. Sidi Sharif Al-Faisal, wishing Rabi Thani Mubarak greetings. And do remember the Maulid Mubarak greetings as well to Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, his parents and family, IFC family. Shukran Sidi Sharif. Siti Mari McGee, Sidi Bilal, Sidi Elijah from Richmond, Virginia. Welcome, thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. Sidi Asha Bakas, Sidi Sherry Bakas, Sidi Rajab, and all the family from Brothers Village, East Bank, Barbados, in Guyana, South America, welcome. Wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak, Maulid Mubarak. So, alhamdulillah, you remember both greetings tonight. Rabia Thani Mubarak and Maulid Mubarak greetings to our beloved Pious Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, your beloved Noor Pearson family, and the Maurice admin staff, the entire IC family. Shukran. Sidi Asha for remembering everyone and for mentioning my parents and family. May Allah SWT bless you, bless your entire family. And Sidi Asha says, completed Wir Alam twice today after Fajr, after Maghrib, and one page of the Quran up to chapter 7. Alhamdulillah, very nice, very nice. Sister Nafisa Nabi and family from Princess Song in Trinidad, welcome. Sidi Hasib, Siti Asya, Siti Asil, Siti Nusheen, Siti Arm, Siti Akif from Brampton, wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak. Do remember the Maulid Mubarak greetings as well. Brother Keith McDonald, this is all about one from Toronto. So Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings, IFC family, shukran. Sidi Shamir, Sidi Samir, Sidi Amir, Sidi Shabir, Sidi Shafir, Sidi Shazia, Sidi Sadika, Sidi Alima, Sidi Medina, all from Queens, New York, in the United States. Welcome to all of you. Sidi Halim Ali from Brampton, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Siti Halima Khan and family from Markham, welcome. Wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak. I shall also include a Maulid Mubarak greetings as well throughout the season of Rabia, first half and second half. This is Bibi Ibrahim, Brother Muhammad Ibrahim, and family from Pembroke Pines in Florida, United States, welcome. Alhamdulillah. So tonight is Rabia Thani Mubarak because the month of Rabia Thani, the second half of Rabia, has begun tonight. And do remember the Maulid Mubarak greetings, Alhamdulillah. Sidi Maulana Tariq Al-Faisal, Sidi Karin Al-Faisal, Bibi Amana from QREP in Trinidad in West Indies. Welcome to all of you, Alhamdulillah. Sister Abida and Sister Shamaila from and family from Manchester, United Kingdom. Welcome to all of you, Alhamdulillah. Recited 5 juz of the Quran today and 25,000 salawat. Alhamdulillah. Siti Wahida Shah Lachman and family from Avocat Jamaat in Trinidad in the West Indies. Welcome, Alhamdulillah. So some of the brothers who are involved in cricket, playing cricket and so on, they were telling me that West Indies lost in the T20 World Cup. They were knocked out in the first round. And it was like a disappointment, they were telling me, the brothers, especially from the West Indies, because they were expected to do well. They had actually won the championship 2 times in the past, and they were knocked out by a country that was a low in the rank, Ireland, not supposed to be a strong cricketing country. Next time, inshallah. So I told the brothers, make sure you do your dhikr and make dua, inshallah. And Siti Halima Khan says, for the Suratul Ikhlas Khatam, complete, pledge 1,000 and completed it, and pledge another 1,000 and complete 200. So this is a Siti Halima, so 2,000 and completed the 1,000, and for the 2,000 completed 200 so far. Very nice. So you out of 2,000 you finish 1,200. So maybe tomorrow night you can do it like that. If you do some more out of 2,000 you finish, if you do another 200 it will be 1,400, like that, inshallah. Very nice, very good, Siti Halima. I want all of you to be reciting the Ikhlas Khatam. Sidi Ansar Afridi from Karachi, Pakistan. Welcome, Sidi Ansar, all the way from Pakistan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Sister Bibi Zamino Razak and family from Cotton Tree Village, West Coast, Barbados, Guyana, South America. Welcome. Thanks for joining us. Sidi Mariam, Sidi Bilal, Sidi Elijah from Richmond, Virginia, wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings to our beloved Pious Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, your beloved Noel Pearson family, the Murees, Admin staff, and the IFC family. Alhamdulillah. Thanks very much for remembering everyone and for mentioning my parents and family, especially. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your family. So once again, brothers and sisters, you just read through Sidi Mariam Magee greetings. See how she's doing it. Write it down, copy it. So you can do it in the same way, inshallah. She arranges things properly. Sidi Amar also do it like that, in a nice way. So you can all, you know, try to do it like that. So you can improve how you're doing your greetings. Sidi Raja Khan, Sidi Tariq from Scarborough, welcome. Sidi Yasmin and family from Bowmanville, welcome. So it is Rabiul Awwal finish. Then from tonight it is Rabia Thani, Mubarak greetings, and Maulid Mubarak greetings to Ashifam. So Siti Razia can retype that in the chat, inshallah. Siti Bibi and Sanali from Pigeon Island, east coast of Demerara, Guyana, South America. Welcome, Siti Bibi and Sanali. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. We hope you can join us every night, inshallah. And do remember to remind the other sisters and brothers, the Murids and other Muslims about the program. Call them, tell them to sign into the chat, inshallah, look at the program. Sister Shireen Shah from Brampton, welcome. Wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings to Sheikh Faisal, the admin staff, entire FC family. Hope everyone is well. Shukran, shukran, Sister Shireen. Suratul Ikhlas Khatam, 300 recited. Today, for a total of 700 completed from the pledge of 1,000. Very nice. 700 completed of the pledge of 1,000. Very good. Sister Shireen Shah, great progress. Inshallah, we finish it soon and take another khatam, inshallah. Another share of 1,000. Sister Mariska Jenny, Brother Muhammad Ma'azam, from Mississauga, welcome. And Sister Mariska Jenny requesting dua for her brother-in-law Umair, who has exams next month. Alhamdulillah, we make dua for him, include dua for Umair. He is doing his bar exams to become a lawyer. Inshallah, alhamdulillah, we want to wish him success in his exams. We make special dua for him, inshallah. And Mariska, you try to encourage him to make sure he's studying and preparing well, focusing on his studies, his exams, and so on. Brother Muhammad Muazzam, welcome. Alhamdulillah, shukran. Siti Halima Khan says, Salwat Project 3,000 today for a total of 286,000. Quran Project, Abu Surat Ali Imran, recited Read Alam 3 times a day. Very good. Alhamdulillah. Sister Shirin Jabbar and family from Scarborough, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Sister Brenda Williams and family from Harlem, New York. In United States, welcome. Wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak and Maulid Mubarak greetings to IFC family. Grateful for Allah's blessings and on the entire IFC family. Salwat today, 1,200 for a total of 104,000. Quran Project up to Surah number 14. Very good. Sister Shamin Subhani from Balmain in Couva, Trinidad in the West Indies. Welcome, Sister Shamin Subhani. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah, we hope you can join us every day, inshallah, 7 p.m. Toronto time. And do remember to tell your Muslim friends about the program and encourage them to watch the program, sign into the chat, inshallah. Siti Hawa Vivian, Siti Uzair from Los Angeles, United States, welcome. Wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings. And you should also remember the Maulid Mubarak greetings. So Rabia Thani, tonight is the first night of Rabia Thani and Maulid Mubarak greetings throughout the season of Rabia. The first half and the second half. Siti Ali Khan and family from Ottawa, welcome. So it's Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings, because Rabia Thani has started, inshallah. So you can update the information in the chat, inshallah. And Maulid Mubarak greetings, very good. Alhamdulillah. Sister Roxana Begum and family from Brampton, welcome. Quran Project up to Surat Ali Imran, Salawat Project 3,000 today for a total of 917,000 Salawat. Make dua for you and families requested. Sidi Dr. Tahir Chowdhury from California, welcome. Wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings to Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal and IFC family. And today completed 6,000 Salawat for a total of 879,000 Salawat. We said one page of the Quran up to Surat number 7. Very good, Sidi Tahir Chowdhury. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. You're making great progress. Alhamdulillah. Brother Ahsan Shabir and family from Italy. Welcome all the way from Italy. Thanks for joining us from Italy. Please tell other Muslims in Italy about the program. Encourage them to watch your program, inshallah. Make dua for you and your family is requested. Sidi Zahir Ihsan and family from San Diego in the United States. Welcome. Alhamdulillah. Okay, Sidi Zahid, let us know if you're a baseball fan and how your team is doing. I think they're called San Diego Padres or so. You can let us know in the chat if you are a baseball fan. Alhamdulillah. Thanks for re-entering the correct information in the chat, inshallah. City Marzana Tasmin from North York. Welcome to you and your family. Alhamdulillah. Rabi Thani Mubarak and Maul Mubarak greetings, Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal and the IC family. Shukran, Siti Marzana, Alhamdulillah. And Siti Marzana said, Quran project of the Surah Al-Baqarah, Dhikr project, recited the word Alam twice today, and Salawat project, 11,300. Okay, so do remember to enter your daily amount, how many you recited today, and then the total for the year so far. Aunty Betty Amina Dean from Toronto, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. And Aunty Betty recited a Surah class 1,000 times today, mashallah. Finish 6,000 out of a total of 10,000. So Aunty Betty took 10,000, alhamdulillah. And finished 6,000 out of the 10,000, mashallah. So this is the highest number, 10,000, 10 shares, and finished 6,000 already. So you can all do it, inshallah. It's a great blessing for you, great opportunity. When you do this for a great Waliullah as Al-Hajj Sheikh Amir Khan, you know, you get great blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves his special friends, his awliya. See, this is Arun family from Toronto. Welcome. Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings. Maulana Mubarak greetings to Sheikh Faisal family, IFC family. Shukran. Sid Marzan says, Sheikh, kindly make dua for my family members. We make dua for all of them. We include that in our niyyah tonight, inshallah, along with all those who requested dua. And Sidi Zahir says, completed 3,000 Surat al-Ikhlas out of the total pledge of 3,000. And she pledged another 1,000, so 4,000, alhamdulillah, for Sidi Zahir. And completed 3,000 so far. Very good progress, very good, alhamdulillah, very nice. And we make dua for you. Sorry to hear you're not feeling well. We make dua for you. Siti Zahirul, inshallah. Do remember the Fatiha Wadifa for Shifa. You get a glass of water, you recite Surat al-Fatiha 7 times, blow in the water and drink the water. And do that every day. In the morning, first thing when you wake up, you do that before eating or drinking anything. During the day, you do it as often as possible. Remember the Fatiha Wadifa. And Brother Muazzam says, Sheikh, what's the best way to respond to non-Muslims who wish Happy Diwali and Halloween, etc.? It's a ticklish point because you want to be careful about, you know, people who are doing shirk, and, you know, these things are based on shirk. But, you know, you can say same to you. Same to you. There's the analogy I want to mention that, like there are some people in the time of the Prophet ﷺ, they would greet the Muslims, And sometimes they didn't mean well. They had ulterior motives. So the Prophet told the Sahabas to say, Alaikum, meaning unto you, rather than saying, Wa alaikum as-salam. So, Alaikum, Alaikum. Which means, to you be the same. What it is, if you want to wish me something good, I respond to you like kind. But if you are trying to harm me or say something derogatory like that, then alaikum, upon you be the same. In this way, inshallah. So, same to you, because that's an expression which is used for greetings and so on. So they would understand that. Because at the same time, you want to see how you can build relationship with people, good relationship with them, non-Muslims, co-workers, friends, neighbors, and so on. But your niyyah is that you want to bring them closer to Islam. You want to get them to understand Islam. You want to hopefully convert them to Islam with the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you want to build a relationship with them. You can then tell them about Islam. So if you respond this way, same to you, for the greetings now, it's Diwali and Halloween, end of the month and so on. Then you maintain that relationship. So when it comes Ramadan, you can say Ramadan Mubarak, Eid Mubarak, and so on, right? Rabi al-Awwal Mubarak, Maulid Mubarak, and then you want to know what is it? Well, we're celebrating the birthday of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because they know about that. They know about celebrating birthday. So it's a good way for you to communicate with them. So you have to have this wisdom in Dawah. You know, like Christians, they celebrate the birthday of Prophet Jesus. I mean, we're not saying what is right, what is wrong, no, but that's how they are. So you want to reach out to them in that way, that they can understand your message, so you can bring them closer to Islam, and hopefully they can accept Islam. That's what you always want to do, always want to do Dawah. So I was same to you, inshallah. Hope that answers your question. Brother Muazzam, let us know in the chat. Alhamdulillah. And Sister Shireen responds to Sister Zairul, so sorry to hear that you're not feeling well. And Zairul, may Allah grant you healing. Alhamdulillah. Shukran, Sister Shireen. May Allah bless you, Sister Shireen. Thanks for responding. Alhamdulillah. And Sister Zairul says, thank you, Sister Shireen. Very nice. I appreciate that. Alhamdulillah. So, Brother Muslim, you can let us know about that. What I'm suggesting for you to do, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, those are the brothers and sisters in the chat. We would make dua now for everyone. Everyone in the chat, special of all of them, for taking the extra effort to sign into the chat, to update on different greetings and projects that they're doing and so on. Engaging in the chat is very good. Inshallah. Then dua for all of you, everyone watching the program online, and for the entire FC family. We make dua for them, inshallah. And Brother Muhammad Muazzam says yes. Okay, alhamdulillah. Very nice. I agree with the Sheikh. We make dua for all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before. You know, whenever you have time, whenever you have the opportunity, make a donation to the Islam Forum. Don't wait for us to ask you. Your donation is always needed, because the more donations we have, the more we can do and serve the community, inshallah. So don't hesitate. You do that. Whatever small amount, you go to the website and do it online, inshallah, as often as you can. You know, like Sidi Mahmoud Al-Hassan, every day he goes to the website and he makes a small donation. This is nice, alhamdulillah. If you're very busy, then you can do ongoing donation, like right now for Rabi al-Awwal, we had the appeal. Now for Rabi al-Thani, we'll have the daily appeal for the month of Rabi, and so on, inshallah. So your donation, make do of all our donors. All those who are participating in the Surat al-Ikhlas Khatam, make do of all of them. All those who have registered for the Remembrance Day Maulid, we make special of all of them. And all the other requests for dua, we include that in dua, inshallah. So please raise your hands and join me in dua. Allahumma ameen. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغلوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بكثرة عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به الوقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وقوت الأرواح وغذائها وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صلاة تنجينا بها من جميع الأحوال والآفات وتقضي لنا بها جميع الحاجات وتطهرنا بها من جميع السيئات وترفعنا بها عندك أعلى الدرجات وتبلغنا بها أقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة وبعد الممات في الحياة وبعد الممات وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين 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 Do remember to type آمين in the chat for the دعاء that you can get more blessings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase in tawfiq and qubul and ziyadah. We thank you for watching the program tonight. We hope you can join us every night, 7 p.m. Toronto time. Do remember to tell everyone you know, your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims, you know, tell them about the program and encourage them to watch the program. Remind them to watch the program, sign it into the chat. Inshallah, they'll benefit and you'll receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I also want to mention, with respect to the question from Brother Muazzam about Diwali, Halloween, and so on. We talk about the greetings like people at work or neighbors would greet you, so it's the same to me to you, fine. But you should not participate in any of these on Islamic festivals. Like, for example, Halloween. You shouldn't have Halloween decoration in your home. You shouldn't be doing trick-or-treating and so on. No, none of that. Do not participate, because these things are based on shirk. You don't want to practice it, to encourage your children to do it. You know, you shouldn't be participating in these things. You know, show them the better way. Show them the better way. Show them Islam in that way, inshallah. I just wanted to mention that as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. We hope to see you again and again and again. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you always in the shade of His special mercies. Until we meet again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.